Okay, this video is designed as an introduction to delivery command, and in particular the dashboard. So if you go to the delivery command webpage here and go to the top right hand corner and log in with your credentials, the first page that you'll be taken to is in fact the dashboard. Now the dashboard summarizes for all of your stores their operational efficiency or metrics. The first thing you might notice here is this weather section. It shows the next 24 hours of weather for your local area. And as you all know, it's important to be able to know if it's going to rain, so you can schedule on more drivers to deal with the increased demand that happens with rainy days. There's a table here that summarizes for all of your individual stores how many deliveries they've completed, the average delivery time, the round trip time, etc. And if you are to click on a particular row, then the dashboard will update just for that store's data. If you unselect that row again, it'll summarize it for all stores. So if we just look at Hornsby here, we can see this wheel. And what the wheel shows us is a detailed breakdown of the driver's performance in delivery. So the gray area is the response time. That's the time for the drivers on average to leave the store. Red is the delivery time, so that's how long they're taking to get to the customer. Yellow is the time spent with the customer. And blue is the time back to the store. Now, blue is a bit bigger than red because the delivery time actually should take into account the response time plus the delivery time. That's the total time to get to the customer. And you can see that fairly closely matches how long it's taking them to get back to the store as well. The average round trip time is 20 minutes and 47 seconds for Hornsby. Then we have a breakdown of deliveries per day. So you can see some seasonality across the week in your deliveries. Obviously, Friday is the busy day, followed by Saturday, and then a gradual decline through the week and a build up Thursday, Friday, Saturday again. The bar chart below the wheel takes the data in the wheel, which is averages for all drivers, and breaks it down on a per driver basis. So you can really see which one of your drivers is your best driver and exactly where they excel or could deal with some extra training. So, for example, Nikki here has a really quick response time or time to leave the store, so that's fantastic. In comparison, Tan here is a bit longer, almost a minute and a half longer just to leave the store. Ty, for example, takes a long time to get back to the store, so you might want to investigate why that may be. And Gustavo here, you can see his delivery time out to the customer is the best across the board. To the right of this, we have a heat map, a delivery heat map, which shows the geospatial distribution of where your orders are actually taking place. Overlaid on a map with your store boundary, you can see this polyline of your boundary is given there. And this could be useful for if you're thinking of opening up another store, exactly being able to determine where the best location for that store may be, or if you want to target some marketing or advertising, you have an idea of where your customer base is located, so you can really target that marketing accurately. And that's it for the dashboard.